City, 1932. The streets teemed with sights and sensations that existed nowhere else. What could capture the rhythm, the vital pulse of such an exciting time and place? The idea for a spectacular show featuring a line of precision dancers formed in the mind of the famed showman Roxy Rutherford. He would call his dancers the Roxyettes and star them on the biggest stage show ever seen in America. Opening night was an event for the history books. Backstage, the dancers suited up, finding their butterflies, excited to premiere their routines for an audience of VIPs. Socialites and politicians tried out the new plush seats and found themselves gasping at the scale of it all. Out front, the red carpet was marked with show business luminaries and sports figures. There were 19 acts on the bill that night, but the ones who stole the show were the Roxyettes, who in short order would have their names streamlined to the Rockettes. Rockettes became a sensation, performing all kinds of dances, but none more popular than their holiday routines, done between movie showings as a Christmas gift to Radio City patrons. The tumultuous events of the 1940s saw the Rockettes leaving their home at the Music Hall to entertain American troops halfway around the world. In the 50s and 60s, they would create happy memories for a whole new generation of fans. By now, the Rockettes were TV stars in their own right, as much a part of New York City as its famous skyline. One success followed another, the Rockettes were riding high. But the 1970s brought hard times for New York and for Radio City. Would the Music Hall close its doors? Had the Rockettes reached the end of the line?
They try to determine whether or not Radio City Music Hall can remain open.
Just after midnight, an agency of the state government of New York agreed to step in to keep the Music Hall show on.
I love New York.
The comeback of Radio City Music Hall would parallel the renaissance of New York City itself. With the incredible 1999 renovation and gala reopening of the Music Hall, once again Radio City made headlines around the world. And the tradition goes on. For Radio City and the Rockettes, there will always be new horizons to explore, new adventures in the world of entertainment, and a New York City that Roxy Rutherford could hardly have imagined. But the Christmas Spectacular will always be the Music Hall's signature event and the one most loved by its stars, the Radio City Rockettes.
Let Christmas shine bright. is that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And Joseph went up from Galilee unto the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, to be taxed with Mary as his espoused wife, being great with child. And so it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered.
And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the fields, keeping watch over their flocks by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them and said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord.